Montana's news leader, this is the MTN Noon News.
Good Wednesday afternoon and welcome to the Noon News. I'm Victoria Hill in for Andrea Lutz. Coming up, January 1st is a big day for marijuana dispensaries in Montana. We'll show you how they're getting ready, but first. As the nation sets a record for COVID numbers, we're taking a look at what's going on here in Montana. Montana health officials reported more than 400 new cases on Tuesday, and the death toll has now climbed above 2,900, with 5 new deaths reported. Gallatin County led the way with 159 new reported cases. There are currently 121 COVID patients in Montana hospitals. A real estate agent and Missoula area pastor is suing the Missoula and National Association of Realtor Groups. You may recall Brandon Huber of Clinton is accused of violating the National Association's Code of Ethics after making statements on the gay and transgender community. Huber's attorney says the realtors want to purge Bible-believing Christians from the profession. The LGBTQ plus Real Estate Alliance says the case is not about religious freedom, but rather the realtor's right to prohibit discriminatory behavior by its members. Two Montanans are waking up millionaires this morning. The drawing for this year's Montana Millionaire was Tuesday morning with the winning numbers of 233771 and 100451. The first winning ticket was sold in Missoula and the second was sold in Butte. This year, for the first time ever, the event has two grand prizes instead of just $1 million prize. Tickets sold out in a record-setting 6 days. There were also two early bird prizes. One was announced on November 26th for $25,000 and another on December 17th for $15,000. Both of those winning tickets were sold in Billings. Anyone working on a minimum wage salary will see a bump in their pay come January 1st. MTN's Jonathan Embarian has the details.
In 2007, a voter-approved initiative took effect in Montana that adjusts the minimum wage every year to account for inflation. Since that time, the minimum wage has never increased as much in a single step as it's about to on January 1st. The 45-cent increase at the start of 2022 compares to a 10-cent increase this year, a 15-cent jump in 2020, and a 20-cent increase in 2019. In September, Montana Commissioner of Labor and Industry, Lori Esau, confirmed the minimum wage would rise to $9.20 an hour. In her announcement letter, she said the reason for the larger increase is higher inflation. Montana's minimum wage is indexed to the Federal Consumer Price Index, which rose more than 5% from August 2020 to August 2021. According to the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics, a wide variety of items are more expensive than a year ago. But gas and other energy prices, along with vehicles, are particularly driving the rising index. Montana leaders estimate almost 9,700 people in the state earned the current minimum wage or less in 2020. Most of them worked in service occupations, particularly restaurants and retail stores.
While this is the largest single jump in Montana's minimum wage since 2007, it's not the most it's increased in a year. In 2009, the wage rose by 35 cents an hour in January, and then another 35 cents in July when the federal minimum wage was increased. In Helena, Jonathan Ambarian, MTN News.
You've made it to the hump. Get over the hump as quickly as possible. And to the weekend we go as we get ready for a brand new year. We're going to start to see some warming up as we get into the first part of next week. But the next couple of days, still seeing that roller coaster ride with our temperatures. Arctic air mass blankets the region, retreats a bit tomorrow, then comes back in on Friday, and then gets on out of here as we get into the weekend, allowing us to finally warm up, trying to get back to seasonal. Let's talk about our highs today. We'll go with a high of 9 in Kalispell, 14 in Missoula, 5 in Helena, -2 in Lewistown. We could see a high of 3 today in Billings, -4 in Miles City, down in northern parts of Wyoming, Cody at 11, Sheridan getting up to 9. Just very cold out there today. Full forecast just around the corner.
January 1st is an historic day in Montana as people can legally buy recreational marijuana for the first time. And many Butte dispensaries are anticipating a busy and uncertain new year.
Try to be overprepared if anything, and brace for a storm and hope we just handle it like pros.
Many are concerned if the supply will meet the expected high demand.
is there going to be enough flour in the state for demand? Mm-hmm. And that's a big question, I think, on a lot of providers' minds.
With about 40,000 medical marijuana patients in Montana, dispensary owners say many customers have been stocking up on cannabis in case the supply is drained.
It's kind of like the COVID toilet paper mentality where I need to make sure I have enough, and therefore the other person might not be able to get some.
Recreational cannabis sales will be taxed at 20%, and Butte Silver Bow is considering a 3% local tax on top of that. Providers accept these potential taxes on their product.
Because I think all people should have access to cannabis. You know, I think it's a safer alternative to opioids. I think it's safer than alcohol. People should have access.
Here at Apogee Gardens, they're stocking up on their edibles, their concentrates, the bud or the flowers, because they're really anticipating a huge opening day.
It's going to be a lot of sales, so a lot of tax revenue next year, and that's a big deal for the state.
As someone who, you know, has been fighting for this for a very long time, it's good to see it's finally coming around.
Many providers say they don't want medical marijuana taxed. In Butte, John Amy, MTN News.